Morning dear children, I hope you are doing the exercises of the English grammar. The second chapter I have asked you to do the exercises for the relative pronoun, and today we are going to study about the preposition. You all know the preposition plays very important role in English grammar. Without preposition, the subject, noun, pronoun of the sentence cannot be related well with the work done by it, and therefore preposition plays very important role in English grammar. Let's understand. Preposition shows relationship between noun, pronoun. Preposition is a word that is used to link noun or pronoun with other words in a sentence. Link means provide relationship between noun and other words in any sentence and make the sentence complete. Okay, to give complete meaning or complete sense to the sentence, a preposition is used. Now, before we go into the topic, I request you just to look up this and understand first. Remember these things. These are the clues for which you got to use the preposition according to the sentences. As for the need, for example, preposition of the time. Example, when. Remember the word when. In, on, at, before, after. Suppose related to the precise time. Time, precise time, exact time, or special time of the year. Day, date, since, while, during, within, until. Okay, you have to remember this. Now, preposition of direction. Remember the word which. Up to, into, half, from, for, by. Now, next we have preposition of place. Remember the word where. About, below, under, between, with, over, in, on, at. And next, preposition of movements. Movements. Out of, down, over, up, into, along, under, through, across, from, past, to. Okay, this you must remember this. Let us now take one by one. You read the first sentence. Look at this first sentence. The kite is flying above, over the tower. Here, when we speak precisely means exact location of the place. You can say over. The kite is flying over the tower means precise. Suppose you don't know exact location of the place, so you can use the word above. Okay, precise means over. Then you do not know exactly precise. So in general you are saying the kite is flying above means you don't know the location. Okay, that time you use above. Second, you see the cow is grazing below under. Now for the opposite of above is below. Over is under. Under here it means precise. You can say the boy is standing under the tower. Under the tower exactly precise. And below the tower you don't know the location, so you say below the tower. Okay. Next, he is standing between the trees. Between the trees. Between is used to show between two persons. Between means one person to another. Okay, showing the between. He is standing between the trees. Now next sentence. I saw him among the players. Suppose more than two, too many are there. In that you want to specifically mention something is there. So I saw him among the players. So among the players, I saw that person. Okay, so more than 2 persons, more crowd is there, in that you see particular, okay, particular person, then you say yes, I saw him among the crowds. Fifth one, the elephant walk across the field. Across means just you have the road. See, you consider this is a road, straight road going. Going like that. Across means just going between here, going here. Is called across. Okay. Next we have the procession went along the road. Along the road, you see the picture here. Two. This is a road, and then this side you go. Along means that side you go. Means close to the road, you keep on walking. That is called occur. When you say that, you have to use the word along. Now next, the train went through the tunnel. Through means showing the direction. How it went? Went through the tunnel. Okay, it went through the tunnel. Direction through. He kept the books on the table. This also here we see. It can be place or direction. Anything can be come. Okay, on the table. But depends on the sentence. Sentence where it is being used, accordingly you must use the word on or into. He threw the books into the table. Into the table, just into the table means keeping only. And you use it in different sense. Okay, one is on the table, onto the table. Onto the table means just throwing, keeping there. Next, he put 5 rupee coin into the machine. Into the means, into, when you use the word into, onto means, it is preposition of movement. Into the machine means showing the movement. There is a movement. Okay, that's why into the machine. What he did? He put the 5 rupee coin into the machine. Okay, now let's go into the garden. Movement, there is a movement. Going from one place to another is a movement. Okay, into the garden. Okay, expresses movement. Into all expresses movement. We walk to the station. So, to also shows the movement, or it also shows from one place to another, where you are moved from one place to another. That's why it's called movement. Okay, next we have the sentence. He traveled from Delhi to Jaipur. From showing the movement from one place to another. Okay, next. I shall finish my work by Monday. Monday. Okay, now you see by can be used to show the precise particular moment of period, or before, or no later than means particular time, until particular time. I will finish my work by Monday. I will submit the assignment by next week. Specifically speaking about period of time, duration. Okay, then we should use by. Next we have, they have been working since Sunday. Since, when you use the word since, means from that moment onwards. Since, okay, from that moment onwards, showing the period of duration. This also showing the duration. So the thing, the prepositions are used depending on the 3 types, that is preposition of place, preposition of time, preposition of direction, and then preposition of movement. So accordingly the prepositions are placed. And you know that without preposition, as in the without preposition, the subject or noun, pronoun or the sentence cannot be related well with the work done by it. Okay, in order to show how they are related and show the work done by the subject, so prepositions are used in English grammar. Therefore, they play very important role in English grammar. So, dear student, I request you to go through the textbook one by one. One by one, what is given. And these are the words, whatever the words are given in the place of preposition of time, preposition of place, preposition of direction and movement. You have the words given in the book, textbook, one by one. I request you to go through it and I also request you to do the exercise which are given in the textbook. And wish you all the best and see you in the next class. Thank you. God bless you.